for surprises has always been a tournament where the favorites were struggling, dropping down to unusual strategies, and I feel this could also be the way for yours to beat Warchief with the non-standard that made him so famous in the WCA European qualifier last year, and of course as well Indian Chuan at the main event.
And I think this, the match that we're getting into here in just a minute, Yaws versus Rich, I think it's very interesting, the first map pick. It was Yaws' pick. They eliminated Twisted, Turtle Rock, Nomad Isles, Last Refuge. We're left with Echo, Amazonia, and Tyranus. And the first map pick for Yaws is Echo Isles. And we've seen him pull off some really cheesy strats before, and we know he loves the mind games. I think we're going to see something weird. I think Yaws wants to get into Rich's head.
Here he is, Warchief Rich Richards, started from England, 23 years old, playing, of course, the Night Elf race. His biggest achievement was definitely the win last year in the Grand Final versus Yaws. This is a rematch from last year's finals. He is the King of Europe in WCA. They also met in the winner bracket quarterfinal, just like today. And there, Yaws was able to tear him down in a 2-1. He then dropped out to 1-0. But that's not a shame. 15-time Jarrah Cup champion, that is a record standing strong. His recent performances were quite good, second places in Jarrah Cups, and for Yaws we can't say the same. 26 years old he is, from Germany of course, a community favorite. 26, of course, playing the human race, a former German champion from the EPS and the runner-up from both the European WCA qualifier and WCA 2015. His Jarrah Cup performances not so great, but he's not playing that really. He's not showing off. Here we go. Game number one. And it's gonna be a slobber knocker, most likely. Warchief Rich, before he was called Robo Rich, playing the Demon Hunter all the time, and this time it's a Warden on Echo Isles. But Yaws, his counter is already here. Hello, Mountain King.
All right, he has something prepared. Of course, the Warden has to be expected on Echo Isles. I was expecting a lot of aggression, early aggression from Yaws, but with an MK. Can you do that with an MK? Usually we say he's weak before level 3, same goes for the Warden, but yesterday we saw actually, it was Foggy making the Warden work very well with early aggression before level 3. Maybe this time it's going to be with the MK. By the way, if you want to show it, Neo, in the chat, there was a little bit of friendly banter going on between the two of them, where Yaws was asking for Rich to be gentle to him. And you can see the history is there. And Rich also saying that he wanted to dodge Yaws. Yaws maybe now, not in the strongest shape we've ever seen him, but it is like the mind games. Yeah. Yaws is very strong with the mind games, and I think Rich, he wants to have a straight up game, a normal game, a ladder game, the thing he's practiced. But Yaws probably wants to shake that up.
Definitely, but with the Mountain King, this is already a surprise. We were kinda hoping for a tower push early on because he knows Warchief inside out. He knows that there's gonna be a counter expansion. He knows that he has to pressure this, but let's see what the Warden is finding. Here it is, Claws of Attack plus 9. Okay, but not a game breaker. Not the Boots of Speed, not the Pendant of Energy. So that's okay for Yaws. He built two farms already, so he knows what's up in the main base. He knows what's up down at the expansion. So whenever Rich is moving out, Yaws knows about this. And that's a small but cool move.
Yeah, I really like this. The farm in the main, of course, is super standard, but I really like the second farm because he expects a counter expansion to be coming up and he wants to see when the Warden is coming in.
Warchief already with the Huntress Hall. Last time these guys played each other, it was Yaws coming in with a tower push. This time, Warchief with a Huntress push, maybe? No, okay, there's the expansion. He plays it very safe then. Of course, with archers, it's not that easy, but maybe he's expecting a big militia push or something?
I imagine he wants to set up the expo and pressure with Huntresses so that he can safely get the expo up behind this. He scouted the MK, by the way. The Wisp was scouting, seeing the Merc camp being taken, so he's not super blind expanding, but he has no proof yet that there is actually going to be an expo coming. Of course, we can see it here with the four militia running south and setting up the expansion. This will be level 3 for the MK, which obviously he so desperately desires. Has found, by the way, the Periapt of Vitality. So the MK, already a tanky dude, is going to be even harder now for the Warden to take down. Speaking of which, she hit level 3. She's at the shop, gets the boots, no staff, There is a wisp nearby that could be used to stab into the main for some fan of knives harassment. We saw that as well yesterday. I believe it was foggy also against yours. Was very effective, but no Rich is coming into the expansion.
And we have no fan of knives. We have Shadow Strike level 2 and Blink already. So he decided to go for that because he knows that there is a Mountain King. He tried to dodge the bolt, but didn't work here. So first little win for yours in this encounter. And the Warden Harass not paying off at the moment. The expansion is coming up. Only a 3 peasant power build. One is building the scout tower for the arcane, obviously. And Warchief is coming with the first Huntress. His expansion is almost up as well. This is very, very fast. And so it's going to be finished before Yoss's town hall, that's for sure. Another storm bolt onto the Warden, but with Boots of Speed, of course, she can run away, she can haunt him. And with the Huntress being scouted now by Yoss, what's his follow-up?
And again, I have to come back to the map here, Echo Isles. I feel this is probably the strongest map for Night Elf. You just see it. It's so easy to get level 3. It's so easy to counter-expand at the same time. It's so easy to pressure then towards the human, where he is forced to be defensive. So all of this working out so well for the elf that already he has the tree completed before the town hall is finished. Of course, mining will start sooner for Yaz. By the way, finding the first bolt kill here as well. But this is lining up so perfectly for the elf, and we see it so many times on Echo Isles, over and over. So that's why I expected something else, some early pressure, some tower push, something. But it seems like Yaz is playing into Rich's hand.
Yeah, and we know the special tactics by Warchief Rich. He has, I think, if as one of the only players in the world, a fast tech to Chimeras for the late game to get rid of the mortar teams and to get rid of the casters and maybe towers, hero focus whatsoever. This is going to be hard for yours. We mentioned it over and over in the cast. We don't know, theoretically, how to beat this. Dragonhawks are an option, but there's going to be Hippogriffs to counter them. Gyrocopters, it's hard because you have to commit to 2 workshops and then you have 4 production facilities with the double Arcane Sanctum, of course. Maybe Knights and Gyros? But of course you need casters for slow against the bears, so this...
We have not yet seen a good answer. Like, we have seen it beaten, but then the human was in a good position to start with, where he had, like, an MK level 3 with, you know, the level 2 bolt, and a few riflemen and water elementals, and then slowly they took out the chimeras. But when there are, like, 4 chimeras on the field, and it's an even playing ground where no one has a big advantage, we have not yet seen the chimeras dealt with effectively.
Yaz has some mercenaries with the Shadow Priest and the Berserker, of course. Warchief wanted to take him out, but one Shadow Strike is not enough for that big damage dealer. Yaz, with a good tech, with a very, kind of fast tech here. Expansion is up. Expansion seems to be safe. Mountain King is coming in for a little harass, but he can't do anything without his army, obviously. Not the craziest damage dealer if he can't bolt. Here comes the next Shadow Strike. This Shadow Priest is definitely gonna go down. And you see the Hunters, the Bouncing Glaives is of course amazing versus Peasants and Footmen.
And the MK, he's walking around with the boots, with the staff, a lot of mobility investment for the Dwarf, and trying to find some openings, scouting at the same time, but he's not able to do too much. He gets a few wisps here. All right. Well, he might be able to cancel the Ancients of Lore with only the MK. You don't see that every day. So that's going to be cool. But what's the fallout for Yaz going to be? Tier 2? Is it going to be the Archmage 2nd with the caster push? We see that a lot from the Chinese humans, where they want to finish the game sooner rather than later. Because, of course, the ever-looming threat of the high-level Warden. It is so tough to deal with.
Oh, nice by Yaz. Canceling the first Ancient of Lore is going to slow down Warchief a lot. Because, of course, he doesn't have 2 Lore, so production is cut in half. We see the Pendant Brewmaster, the favorite second hero by Warchief. And this is kind of interesting and kind of strange that we see that here on Echo Isles. Usually, you want to level the Warden up to level 6 as fast as possible. With the Panda, you slow down the progress of the Warden. Of course, you have more area of effect, and you have a tanky hero up front, but you want the level 5 Warden, and this is not the perfect Warden play I see here. There's no fan of knives and no harass to the economy, so this, in my opinion, is a great start for Yaz into this playoffs. Archmage 2nd, by the way, for casters.
Yeah, see the quite a lot from the Chinese, taking out a page out of their book. Invis Warden now, maybe starting some harass, but yeah, this Warden has not been too damaging. She killed a Berserker, a Shadow Priest, and I think 2 footmen. Usually the Warden gets a lot more done in the early game, so yes, I agree with you. The damage Jaws has suffered wasn't too great, but that's not all there is to it, I feel, because we also have to consider the economic situation. And this being Echo Isles, the Night Elf has a great situation. When we compare the two gold mines at the expansion, it is not even 2,000 gold behind. Usually it's 3,000, sometimes even 4,000. But this is so quick for Rich. He has such a good production. He's going to tier 3. He's getting his structures ready, his infrastructure. And soon, when the 70 supply push comes from Yoss, if it comes, he will have the answers to deal with it.
Yeah, he goes for the Engine of Wind already. This is going to be Fiery Dragons. And then, of course, the tech tree is open to the so mighty Chimeras. I wonder if Yoss is going for Water Elementals or immediately to Blizzard. Because we saw him with this Area of Effect spell. It's so strong. It's a nice combination. If he maybe goes for Clap as well instead of Bash later on. Clap and Blizzard, nice synergy, of course. So far, the Archmage only with the Brilliance Aura, which you need for the casters. First time here in this playoffs. Muddy the Mud Golem, the Back to Warcraft Mascot. And yeah, Rich with another Ancient of War at his expansion. He's really afraid of this push that's to come.
Yeah, I think it's a good choice. It's most likely that the that Yoss is going to be going for some sort of committed attack, kind of an all-in attack. And he has the map control right now. He has the stronger army. Again, this always happens on Echo Isles, it seems. You get the Warden, you get map control, until the human is finally at 70 supply. But of course, it takes so long. So now you can determine what happens on the map. The human can't really move out because he's going to get killed by the army. So Yoss has to take it slow. He has to take the creep camps around his expansion, but he can't really go out any further. And that, of course, means big experience disadvantage. Archmage, you just said it. Only level 1, only the Brilliance Aura, and even if he hits level 2, then it's going to be level 1 Blizzard, which is really not much damage at all, especially against bears. And at the same time, Panda already level 3. I think he bought the Pendant of Energy also, and maybe also the Period. Well, no, that was probably found at the Turtles. And the Warden, also level 4. So, I don't know. If Yoss goes for a big attack, he's now at 70 supply. I don't know that it's going to be a winning one.
Now, Warchief is coming in for the push with 2 heal scrolls and invul potions. So he had chop control, 2 invul potions even. He plays this so safe. I mean, every single step is secured. Every single step has a little backup plan to it. And I like that. He doesn't want to overcommit. He knows the strength of Yoss, so he wants to be ready. Oh, the Stormbolt comes in. Little mana burn from the Spellbreaker's feedback. And the first Mortal Teams are here as well. We, by the way, see Blizzard. This is really Yoss' signature spell, I'd say. This really makes him so strong, and he wants to secure the shop. We mentioned it in our casts over and over and over again. Shop control on Echo Isles is key to victory, and the Ivory Towers are here to protect this.
Rich has still a lot of time. The pressure is not coming towards his expansion yet, but as you're saying, the fortified position is going to be created here. Actually, Archmage with the Ivories is moving far forward. He wants to hit the push towards the expansion sooner rather than later. Maybe a little bit of impatience coming out of Yoss. Maybe he doesn't want to give Rich the time to get to Chimeras. By the way, there's no Chimera Roost yet. Rich has started production, only at 68 though, doesn't want to fight yet. He doesn't really need to. So far, his tree, his expansion, his moonwells, everything's still safe.
I think that's a little mistake by Watchers because he forgot the moonwells. He can't go up to 80 food. He has 500 gold, so there is resources for more units. But okay, Yoss at 80. This is looking good for the German. Very, very good. The Mortar team's in a perfect position. But the Night Elf, what can he do? Militia support is here. Anti-magic potion immediately being used. He can't find the Breath of Fire yet. Yoss' position is absolutely amazing. The Blizzard is rocking in. First Breath of Fire is coming in here. Heal scroll being used by Yoss. The bears are all over the place, though the tower is almost ready.
I know about him taking this fight, but for the time being, the bear is alive. The Warden, taking a bit of damage, has quite the good inventory, though, to still remain alive. Blinking, shadow striking, no fan of knives. Now the anti-magic potion coming in, and the panda is surrounded. He has the invul. Does he have a staff? Also, he has no staff here, by the way. So, tough engagement for Rich, but he seems to be making it work.
Looks like the bears are too strong. Still 69 food. Yoss lost a lot, but Warchief is forced into a town portal. All focus on the panda. Down he goes! The panda not able to save him. And yeah, the lack of a staff cost him the second hero now, and the German is moving forward. The mortar teams are still alive, so strong with their siege damage. The breaker line looks perfect with 2-1 upgrades already. What's the response? Oh, he's trapped! Warchief traps himself with the town portal, has to get rid of the Moonwell. Still at 80 foot though, Circlet lying on the ground here. The Warden not so strong at the moment, getting it now with the Blink. Next, Blizzard is coming in close to level 3, and the Bears are losing HP here. Rejuvenation has been stolen.
But they're moving forward, the Roar is being used.
But there's no Dryads anymore, he can't get rid of the Slow. And this is what the humans want. Slow him down, get the damage with the Mortar teams and the Blizzard, and this looking perfect. Stormbolt on the Warden again. Invo Potion gets Invo Potion trying to get rid of the Mortar team, but the heal is so constant. The Breakers are still standing strong against the
Bears. Look for the Warden, look for the Warden. Where's the Bolt? He doesn't have the mana. That was a close call. And yeah, the Blizzard man, now Archmage level 3, and the Warden jumping in again towards the backline, to the casters, to the priests, to the Mortar teams, but the Bears, they're only inches away from dying! All of them!
Level 2 Blizzard it is, and the the Warden goes down! Level 5 on the
God.
FK! And once again, Yoss is the one beating Warchief. I cannot believe how Mark Förster is making this work over and over and over again versus Warchief. This was the Night Elf map, I think. This one of the strongest Warden maps, and definitely Warchief's strongest map with his Chimera push, but he didn't go for it. Just the perfect timing, perfect executions. But we have to say, Warchief's Warden play was not on point, was not efficient at all.
No, it was not the dazzling Lorliad Warden that we oftentimes see. It wasn't that. He got some damage in early game, but not crazy amounts that catapulted him ahead in the game. But I think he was still in a perfect position. He got the expansion up early. He got the panda to level 3 early. He had great items. He had a big army. He was close to 80 supply, but he makes the big mistake, forgets the Moonwells. Production starts so late, and obviously losing the panda can't do that. Didn't get the staff. I think Warchief had that game in his hands. It wasn't an easy victory or anything, but if he plays it straight up without those mistakes, I think he has a very good chance at winning this.
Yeah.
I think he got too comfortable. I think he thought, I know this game, I've played this map, this matchup so many times, I got my expansion up, my Warden's level 4, my Panda's level 3, easy Katka, this will be the 1-0, but then he doesn't pay close enough attention. Macro mistakes, production too late, of course, again, staff, incredibly big mistake, but all props to Yoss, going for that attack with the perfect timing and the quick upgrades, quick upgrades. Usually, on Echo Isles, there's no Shredder, and the humans always suffer from lumber issues, but this time he didn't. So he was paying very close attention to his resources, perfectly managed, and then, of course, he gets the gift of the panda.
The next map is Warchief's Playground, though. Amazonia, since the dawn of this map, we have seen him with great creep routes, with strong demon hunters, strong panda, strong executions. This is really his map to take now. Echo Isles was favoring the Warden play usually. Amazonia is favoring Night Elf in general.
Yeah, we have seen the Immolation Demon Hunter really wrecking humans lately. And yesterday, Foggy pulling out the Warden. But I don't think we could see in that game. I don't think Rich is as comfortable with the Warden as many other players are. And picking her on Amazonia in the grudge match where it could be dropping down to the low bracket, basically 0% chance. I will bet my house on a Demon Hunter here.
Yeah.
And is it going to be Immolation? Does he like Immolation?
I was asking myself the same question. I don't think so. I think that he picks the Demon Hunter because the mana burn is so strong, because the evasion makes him such a tanky hero, so much toughness, so much effective HP with the dodges. I don't see it. He's not like Foggy who does it all the time. He's not like Sonic who really likes Immolation. But maybe, especially in the games against Yoss, Warchief always tries to do something different and tries to surprise Yoss. So maybe it is Immolation this time. Or on the other side, will we see a rifle push of Yoss without the expansion?
That would be interesting. Does he do that? Rarely.
Yeah, it's a long time
but
ago.
But he's a game ahead. He loves messing with his opponent's head. I could definitely see it.
Yeah.
I think Warden here, he's going to buckle down. He's going to stick to what he's practiced, stick to what he knows, stick to what's solid. So I imagine it's going to be mana burn, no immolation. He's going to hold on to the skill point for the longest time. Yeah. He's going to go down to the expansion to see what's up. Maybe he sees an opening. Maybe he goes for immolation. If he gets, like, I don't know, both water elementals killed with a double wisp detonate or something like that. Maybe he gets a shadow priest as well early from the merc camp with a pull trick. So a lot of damage can be coming out here on Amazonia if Yoss goes for the fast expansion. Yeah. He might be throwing a curveball. He might be going for the rifle push, but we saw that demolished not too long ago with a level 3 demon hunter with good items and a naga quickly to just pressure the human very hard. But there was no chance at all of the rifle push working.
Maybe. On the other side, we saw Foggy versus Yoss also on this map, and Yoss really had no chance against Harry Potter. Couldn't make it work. It was really a very, very one-sided game. Can Foggy? Yeah. Can Warchief play like Foggy here, or does Yoss have the answer?
Well, on the Echo Isles, it certainly did not look at all that Rich's timings were as precise as Foggy's. We of course know Foggy is a practice machine. He studies everything, watches all the replays of his again, tries to figure everything out, of course, plays a hell of a lot as well. So he has a special game plan in mind for Rich here. He's solid, he's strong, but he doesn't seem to have the playbook down of what to do at what point exactly. So I don't think he's going to be finding the same openings as Foggy will for damage.
Yoss is, by the way, still not in the game. Maybe a little mind trick again?
Probably.
Yeah, he knows, okay, this is a good start for me. Take my time, let it sink, especially to watch you. Okay, damn, I'm down now. What can I do? What do I have to do? How do I
let
have
it
to
stew a little bit.
Exactly, and this, maybe this is getting to his nerves with Warchief. We have some stats, by the way, between Yoss and Warchief. Always when there's a big competition in Europe or in general with European participations, these guys meet. And so far, it's 11-0 for Warchief, but it's also close, man. WCA European Pro Qualifier in the group stage, it was a 2-0 for Warchief. In the winner bracket final, he came back, and it was a 1-2, so this was the biggest win of Yoss against Warchief. In the grand final, though, the guy from the United Kingdom with a 2-1 win, and then in the WCA, it was a 2-0 for Yoss. So always, when it's important, it seems like Yoss has the better answer, except in grand finals. And we have 3 meetups in Jera Cups, which were all won by Warchief. So you can say, online, advantage Warchief, offline advantage Yoss. But this is offline. This is online, of course, and Yoss is taking the lead.
Yeah, but it's not only offline and online. Yoss, I feel, really prioritizes heavily, more so than most other Warcraft players. Most of the Warcraft players take Jera Cup seriously. When he played in them, he really didn't take it seriously. He played Tinker first, he played Naga first, he played all sorts of silly things. But now, it seems like even though this is online, not offline, he is taking this seriously. And could we call this an upset? Actually, we can't, right? He's the Vice World Champion.
Yeah.
The last few months would indicate that Warchief is the favorite, but Yoss, man, he's got the silver medal.
That's true. When it counts, he's there. He's not playing the small cups, the small tournaments, but the big ones. The big ones are his to take. Or not to take, but do incredible. So, yeah, the game starts. You can hear it. And it's gonna be so... watch if he has to win this, or he drops down to the loser's bracket. Whew. Pretty intense. Already... after just the first map, we are close to a decision. Match point for this guy, Mark Förster from Andernach, Germany. Very, very comfortable position here for him with the 1-0 advantage, but what does he do? Rifleman, one base, expansion play, we will see about that. Warchief, he knows this map inside out. He has every trick in the book on this map. He knows the perfect creep routes, and he knows how to deal with humans here, of course. Demon Hunter is our prediction for this. No Warden. But we're going to see about that. Are under attack.
And there has been a new strategy. Oh, well, a new deviation, I guess. in this matchup on this map from, you can't even say the Chinese players, just Infi. Infi started doing this, and that is fast expansion, of course, casters, of course, and you know, Archmage first, MK second, all that is the same. But Infi nowadays likes to go for tier 3 later on, add the master upgrades for the casters, and throw in a couple of knights for good measure. And
not to forget about fragmentation shards.
And fragmentation shards, exactly. Crazy strong upgrade, increases the damage by so much. And this has been a very successful strategy. Maybe Yoss is going to try his hand at this. We saw already on Echo Isles, he went for the MK first, Archmage second, with the Blizzard and the Aura with the casters. That's also something that kind of came out of China, maybe, I don't know, 2 months ago or something. Maybe this time he's going to be going for the Infi strat of tier 3. Or, of course, it might still be a one-based play. Rich has to worry about so many things this game.
Indeed, a lot of variety in the human race, and that's what makes it so strong and was the dominant race for 2012 to 2014, I'd say. But then Dawn of the Night Elves, Dawn of the Orcs, and even the Undeads are back, so we have a good mix of races here in Warcraft 3 nowadays. Yoss is going for the expansion. 6 Militia is not too much.
Instant expansion again.
Yeah, not going for the laboratory. This didn't really work versus Foggy. Warchief, of course, saw the games, knows what to do, is almost level 2. Question is, Mana Burn is already skilled, evasion or immolation?
He needs the Water Elemental killer with the Wisp here. But the Water Elementals are fairly healthy. Oh, he's going for an Ancient of War right away. What?
Nice distraction. He has to kill it sooner than later. Otherwise, he will have a big support unit right in Yoss's face. And of course, blocking the bit for the expansion Archmage in kind of trouble here. By the way, still no level 2. He's going for the peasant here. There's the kill. And now we have evasion.
All right. And the Ancient of War, is it actually going to be coming up? Well, the peasants have retreated. The expansion is slowed down by a lot. We have tier 2 also coming from Warchief. No Hunter's Hall, no second Ancient of War. Well, apart from the one, of course, at the expansion, which is going to be taken down here. But is it going to be an expensive kill? It doesn't even kill it.
Yeah, this is really bad for yours. What a reaction by Warchief. This is something new that I haven't seen before. This is something out of Warchief's playbook, and this is exactly the reason why we can't call him Robo Rich anymore.
I wonder, did he like just build that Ancient of War like as a reaction, seeing, alright, I can't get the Wisp detonates here, so what do I do? I guess I go for an Ancient of War. Was it just a spur of the moment thing, or did he practice this? Because it looks so strong, it looks so smart, so unexpected.
Yeah.
I wonder if it was just a moment of brilliance from the genius of Warcraft.
Yoss is not stubbornly trying to expand again. He is going for tier 2. He thinks, okay, the expansion is delayed by so much. This can't really work anymore. So let's try Yoss surrounding skills maybe, but the Archmage is too low on health, so he can't pull it off. Anything's okay. This didn't work. I am slowed down, but if I expand now, my tech will be way too late. He started the tech, and he backs it up with a blacksmith.
Oh, this is so late, though.
Rifle push is usually weaker compared to the two-base play. But now that the tech is delayed and the Night Elf has even more time to get Dryads, to get Bears, Rejuvenation and stuff, this is not effective at all. But maybe Yoss knows what to do. He has a backup plan. Archmage is going to be close to level 3 here. So that's okay, at least. Warchief, of course, with the Troll Trapper. What's the item he had? Okay. Mental Intelligence, not that great. Boots for the Archmage, boots for the Demon Hunter as well. Should make you happy.
Finally they do it right. But I'm looking at this game and I'm trying to put myself in the situation of Yoss's. And where does he go from here? What does he do? Can he just go for the normal rifle strat? He knows he's been delayed by so much. And with a one-base timing push, as the name suggests, the timing's really important. And it's gonna be so late. I would be desperation mode right now if I was Yoss. I would be like, crappity crap crap, what do I do here? I would have no idea, but he is the Vice World Champion. He is pretty goddamn good at this game. I'm gonna be really interested to see what he does.
So you see the timing is off. The first rifleman only produced now. The tech still 20 seconds or something against this Naga by Rich.
Saw that before against the rifle strategy, the Naga push the Naga choice followed by a lot of aggression where the rifleman never reached critical mass. And now chasing for the AM.
Yeah, that's kind of on both sides we have a critical mass. Usually, of course, the Night Elf is under heavy pressure, but they try to get out bears, master bears, of course, that is, versus this strategy. But you need like 3 to 4 bears, and then you can fight the snipers here. On the other side, you need, of course, a lot of riflemen to make it work, to make the focus work against dryads and everything else. So, yeah, both need their critical masses before they can win this fight. No tier 3 tech by Chief so far. This means he's not in a good way to masturbate.
And the Water Elemental scouting this. This is what the Archmage wanted. Spawn a Water Elemental in the main, see the timing for the tech, and now he sees it. Get started at this very second. Yaws is tier 2, but MK still far away. Arcane Sanctum still far away. He has 2 riflemen so far. And he needs a lot more.
Yeah, and there's not the 1-0 upgrade, it only started now. So very, very weird game that we see here. And I think if a game goes non-standard, it always favors Yoss, because he's so good at adapting and mixing in new elements to the usual playstyle. Gonna see about that. Replenishment potion and level 3 for the Demon Hunter. It's gonna be level 2 for the Naga, but from the left comes Yoss. How much damage can he do?
Does he want to fight right now? He has the double slow from the Dryad and the Naga, so the pickoff potential should be great with the Boots of Speed as well. Seems like he's fearing the MK, and he's right to do so, because the little dwarf is coming from the south, and Richard started. The Englishman is retreating. He wants to take a look at the situation. He doesn't want to let the MK creep. I think that's his number one priority right now, and that's why he took away 2 of the 3 goblins, no, what? Not goblins, what are they called? Kobolds? So the MK has a tough time creeping. Where does he go now? Take the natural of the Night Elf? That does not sound like a good idea to me.
Warchief knows about this. There's 2 Dryads parked there for Dispel and of course Slow. Yoss is going for it. Takes out the Mud Golem, so there's no Slow. But here comes the Englishman from the right. Dispel immediately, Water Elemental gone. But the Rock Golem is in a good situation, in a good position. Does he have the time though? No, he doesn't. He has to retreat, he has to back up. Long rifle upgrade coming, but at the same time, tier 3 still needs a few seconds, but he's getting there. Bears are coming in good numbers for Warchief, and the Orb of Venom, of course, will boost the Demon Hunter's damage by a lot.
I was expecting Yoss to be pulling the Militia up here to force the fight and then take the Rock Golem behind this, but he doesn't want to. He doesn't want to risk it. He doesn't want to take a fight yet. Archmage coming in. Is he going to get the last hit? That would have been crazy, but no, doesn't get it. Bad item here for Rich. Finds the one of mana stealing. I guess you can drain the MK instant, but you really want something to survive rather, and this can make a big difference. A greater healing, a greater invul is so strong when you have to fend off a push. Yaw's coming in now for some more creep blasts, but the MK is still only level 1.
This is not good. No bash, no clap. 4 riflemen, and I think his farms are always a little late, so his production is not slowed down by much, but it is. The production is slowed down. 48 food for Warchief. We have 56 for Yaws, so he is economically down now.
Creep Jack.
Yeah, Creep Jack it is, with of course double slow from Dryads and Naga.
Militia have to come from the main. When's he calling him? I think they're coming now, but it's gonna take a little while. Still footmen in this army, not the greatest. They're being picked off now. Yaws already in upkeep, but only 54. And Rich, I don't think he really wants to fight so close to the base where the militia are coming, but I guess he does, losing the first bear. Never mind. Stab at the very, very last second. Dryad will be falling here though. Double level up for Yaws, and this is not a big army for Rich with lots of archers. That's not too strong.
Yeah, nice sniping from Yaws. The Mountain King has to be careful though. There is a potion on the Night Elf heroes, but that's about it. Long rifle upgraded through. 2-0 almost on the rifleman.
Where are the sorceresses? Sorry.
Yeah, there are none.
There's no slow. These bears can easily retreat.
Yeah, that's usually not what you want. Rejuvenation is in the works, but this was a nice engagement by Yaws. Didn't look like it, rather, but... Oh, stun on the Archmage, but He gets away. Boots have been transferred, by the way, to the MK. Scroll of Healing for the German. On the other side, the Naga plus 6 because of the two mantles. That's nice damage. And 2-0 is ready. And Yoz's army is getting stronger and stronger. But once again, the farm... Okay, this is not necessary, but he is getting ready for more than 60 food. Warchief is taking the bigger creep spot here. Gonna be close to level 4. And on hero levels, it's looking okay, right, for Yoz? 4-2, the other guy 3-2. Oh, nice! The MK with the stone, he gets the last!
Oh, it was the Scourge Bone Chimes!
And it was the Scourge Bone Chimes! Incredible for the Bears! And now the Demon Hunter is in problem, has to take the potion. There is, of course, Rejuvenation, but can he keep him alive? Bash! And oh! The potion coming in here. Demon Hunter is still standing strong. And now the Naga is under pressure. The focus from the Rifleman so strong, switching to a Bear, but he goes down. First hero versus the second hero, Demon Hunter, catching another Bash. And he quadrants out. What a fight! Again, the Mountain King in trouble. Whoa. He dies in the last second before the town portal comes in. Holy cow! Except this Mountain King loss. Phenomenal fight by yours.
So unfortunate for Rich. That renegade wizard, that's like suddenly he starts running back. He's like, what the hell, man? I want to kill you. He follows him. But then comes the bolt, steals the last hit, steals the item, and it's one of the greatest items for this map, for this strategy. A lot of bad luck striking Warchief Rich here. But also, a little bit of questionable decisions here. When that engagement, I think, was okay for both sides, kind of. But the engagement before that, where he decided to fight with three bears in a position where the militia will be coming in very soon. Lucky for him, there were no sorceresses, but now there are. There are two. They're starting to gather some mana, and once Slow comes into play, this will not be as easily fightable anymore for Warchief.
Nope. Oh, Demon Hunter here needs rejuvenation again. Both players at the red spot. Yoz, this takes a lot of time, but he has the time, because Warchief is doing the same spot, and war song, battle drums. This is 10% damage on everything, and especially for Riflemen. This is absolutely phenomenal. By the way, no spellbreakers at all. On the other side, Medallion of Courage, which is also not that great. A
player's force. And I think Yoz is hoping for the dream right now to get the Warsong Battle Drums and the Illyrius Rune of Accuracy. So I could see him going down to the Merc Camp, but he's taking his time. Rich has already taken it for the most part. Maybe he's gonna leave the Renegade Wizard again. Nope, this time he kills it.
Embraces, pretty nice against the Mountain King.
Not too bad, not too bad.
Naga level 4, getting more dangerous, but the Archmage Man, 4.6. The only thing that lacks is levels on the Mountain King. Only level 2.3, and he's far away from Stormbolt level 2. This is 58 food for yours, but Warchief has been catching up. 56 for him, and there's no blockers. And there's just a little slow from one sorceress, if I see this correctly. So, Warchief can play the kiting game with the Dryads.
Neo, I think you need glasses, man. This is three sorceresses. What the hell?
Really? Oh, sorry.
So he's got little bit more slow. By the way, no adapt training, so no invisibility saves will be happening. More sorceresses come from the main. No upgrade. By the way, Mass Militia have been called. Is this gonna be the big push where he tries to win the game? He has a strong army, strong items, but the MK still only level 2.
Yeah, this has to be the final nail in the coffin for a Warchief. He goes in with everything. 2 heal scrolls, 1 protection scroll even, and the invul potion. Fork Lightning killing 1 peasant off immediately, 2 are down. The militia duration is over, but they are just here as meat shield. They want to block. This is the blockers that Yard has, and he's trying to go for it with tower distraction.
Alright, when's he gonna engage? 2 more Dryads came out of the Angels of Lore. Is he gonna wait for the next 2 bears? He's gonna lose at least 1 Moonwell for it. But it seems like he wants to buy more time. 1 armor upgrade, by the way, on the bears, but of course, rifles with 2 attack upgrades and the aura.
This is really a lot of damage, and Warchief is giving him the time so far. Sends in the Engine of War as another wood shield to tear down the towers. The bear is not in the perfect position at the moment. Yoz immediately taking out that one wisp. That was really nice.
Alright, the 2 bears arrive from the Ancients of Lore, and I think this is gonna be go time as the creeps join in the battle as well, morphing into master form. Do the bears, where's the roar? Ah, they do have it. Okay, I just can't see it because low quality. But they do have roar. This is a lot of damage. Yoz has to kite like crazy.
First Stormbolt, but as we mentioned over and over, only level 1. The Rifleman can be attacked by the bears. This is a lot of damage, but he is well microing at the moment. Healing used from the Moonwell. One bear staffed out. Warchief also on point at the moment.
MK again in trouble, has to use the invul already. This is significant damage coming out of the bears. Level 5 for the Demon Hunter. And the Rune Bracers coming into play. They're not taking much damage from the bolt, but quite a bit from the MK. Focus. The MK has no more invul, no more TP. GG, the push is not gonna be killing the Rich.
And once again, Amazonia proves to be the strongest map of Warchief. Once again, a battle between Warchief and Yaws goes into the third round, into the grudge match. And yeah, one map away, both players from the winner bracket semifinal. One will drop down to the loser bracket. And this is always fantastic games between the two, man. This is so cool to see.
And we may have the climactic ending as we are going to Tyrannus for the last map.
Ooh.
One of the easiest expansion maps. Very easy to take creep camps. You know, the natural. No, the natural, not so much. But the other one. And the Merc camp, also very easy to take. Both races like that. Both races like expanding. Both like hiring mercenaries. This could be a long one. This could be a game with two expansions. Maybe some tier 3. Maybe some tanks. Maybe some knights. Maybe some gyros. Maybe some griffins. Maybe some chimeras. It might be, of course, again a one base play, but that did not look too successful for Rich, for Yaws. He had some good engagements, but in the end, honestly, the last fight was super easy. He didn't have to do much.
I'm curious if he goes for a Warden again. This didn't work too well, but on the other side, it is Tyrannus then. And Tyrannus has always been, since the days of soccer back then, or even before that,
yeah,
has been the Warden map.
The Warden map, exactly. Before the Night Elves figured out how to do it on Echo, it was always on Twist, on Tyrannus. Well, oftentimes seen, not always, of course. There's some intricacies to Tyrannus, though. I do expect the Warden, actually. I think Rich is still confident in the Warden to a certain extent. Is he going to be going for the natural creep with the Ancient of War that can be greedy, can be punished?
Very greedy. Yaws will has to scout for this.
Yeah.
And then try to tear it down. Or is Warchief so safe that Yaws thinks he goes for a Warden that he might be going Demon Hunter? Because Yaws might be going for a Mountain King? There's so many options in this matchup, on this very map. Really hard to predict.
I like the Archmage though on Tyrannus. It's way more versatile with like Water Elemental Harass, with Zeppelins and stuff. And on Tyrannus, on such a big map, that can definitely come into play. So we see MK first there as well, but as you say, it's such a big gamble, man. What do you do when you run into a Demon Hunter first? It's like crappy crap crap. And I think the way safer pick is the Archmage, and I think that's what he's gonna be going for. But I think also the last map here, Amazonia, where seriously Rich always wins, I don't know how. That is gonna tell y'all something, and that is, don't play one base. That doesn't look good. So I think it is gonna be an expansion game. Question is, how quick is Rich gonna be counter-expanding, and is there gonna be an early push by y'all? Is it gonna be successful? On Echo Isles, it certainly was.
This is so cool, like the pinnacle of Warcraft players. Yeah, we are talking about Foggy and Hawk and Sonic, but I think the encounters of Warchief, this is really a really cool rivalry since last year's WCA. Mm. I mean, so many cool games. We all remember the grand final on TM, where Yaws was so close of killing him, but then Mass Expansion game came out, and epic fights between those two. Well microed, just always a nice little thing that both players add to the to the standard game, like the Ancient of War here, for example, and yeah, it's really cool.
And the one thing I'm surprised about is Yaws hasn't cheesed yet. It was two normal strategies. There was no cheese with like Archmage 4 footmen attacking the main and 8 peasants taking the expansion by themselves. It was straight up normal games. I was expecting some more mind games. We could see it in the chat. He was certainly trying to mind game him a little bit there. Maybe he was a little bit late into the second game on purpose. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe yes, maybe no. But actual in-game strategies, it's clear-cut and obvious.
Okay, we're waiting for UCC to start this game. A little more tension, everything is rising. And yeah, do you think Yas is doing much better today because he can play in yellow, his favorite color?
I know he's a superstitious fellow, like Rich and Rudan and HLA actually. We remember at WCA at Gamescom, they all wanted to play on the left side of the stage because it was lit in blue, and the first game were won by the blue side, so they thought the blue side was the better side. Athletes, cyber athletes or normal ones, seem to be a suspicious bunch. But nah, it's not gonna make a difference. Yellow, red, whatever. But I think he's taking this more seriously than the games in the group stages. I think he thought, I'm gonna get through this easy. These are just some letter scrubs, the two undeads that is. And now he is really trying. He's really trying. Hey. On Echo Isles, he looked very strong. On Amazonia, of course, was a little bit of a different story.
True that. Before in the lobby, Yas was saying how much respect he has for Warchief. He definitely takes this serious, that's for sure.
By the way, we have six games today, right? We have the first round of the playoffs of the grid, upper bracket, of course, and then we're going to have the semis of the upper bracket.
Exactly.
Is that the case? Okay.
That is the case. So this is what we're going to see here today. Of course, the numbers are wrong, but it's 1-1, you know that. Ogworker and Wan is coming up, Sonic Chechi, Foggy Hawk, and then Warchief or Yaws versus Ogworker or Wan. Do you think one of the grids is a little easier?
I think Chechi and Wan are the big underdogs, and everyone else can do well, so I think it's very balanced.
Yeah, I think so too. A little lucky for the lower part that they don't have an orc in there, so they don't really have to prepare for that. But on the other side, there's always the possibility to meet them in the winners' finals or the losers' bracket, so you have to go for it.
And we seem to be getting ready here. Only 10 seconds is what our Russian friends are demanding until the game starts. And Yas is saying it already, the gamble again.
Mm-hmm.
So he is thinking about the warden or the demon.
Yeah.
And of course, picking the MK into the demon hunter would be very bad. I don't think he can go for the gamble. I think that's a bad gamble to go for.
It's hard to say, man. It's really hard to say.
Of course, this might be another mind game out of Yas, reminding Warchief.
There is the option. I could go for an MK.
Exactly.
Maybe get the Demon Hunter ready.
Exactly.
I think it's going to be a Demon Hunter.
Yeah, I think so too. And I also think it's going to be an Archmage. I think both players are going to play this safe. But then again, Yas, very eccentric. We know him. He might be like, fuck it. Let's go MK. Or Blood Mage first. Why not?
True that. Once again, the player sheets here. This is Yas. And Terranus 10. I think the talks are over. The pregame talk was long enough. We covered basically everything that there is to cover. And now the players have to show the result. 1-1. One map into the winner bracket final. Winner bracket semi-final, I'm sorry. So the hero picks will determine the path that this game is going for.
And the first Ancient of War is being placed next to the natural. This means greedy creep camp. This means can be punished. This means opens up a lot of aggressive possibilities for Yas. And this also means that Rich is expecting a fast expansion. That is why he's creeping this. He wants to open it up for a counter expansion. He could be creeping way more easily, way more safely, and get just the same amount of experience, basically, but he wouldn't have the option to counter-expand quickly. So he is putting Yas on the expansion game, and seems reasonable enough. By the way, first hero, Archmage versus Demon Hunter, super standard. He's putting him on the expansion game, and I think that's a reasonable assumption to go for, because again, on Amazonia, the one base play didn't turn out too well. Of course, he was forced into the one base play. He actually wanted to expand. But yeah, so far, Rich reading it right. And that's alliteration.
Yeah, true. Jos has a good gamble as well here, not going for the MK, because Mountain King versus Demon Hunter, you can just imagine how this works with Mana Burn against the MK. It's just a big footman with Bash if you get him to level 2, so that would have been a disaster for Jos. But he's going the safe route, and yeah, you said it's super standard. I do not really agree. The Warden is definitely standard on TS, so Warchief is adapting a little, but as we mentioned after game one, he feels way more secure and way more comfortable with the Demon Hunter as his first hero. In 2014, he still said, why should I pick a different hero than the Demon Hunter? He is the best and he can make everything work. He changed that opinion. Oh, and Yoss is going for the kill immediately. Yeah,
we see this from the Chinese humans as well. Oh, they move south, and if Nidov is there to creep, then they harass. By the way, Lightning Shield denying the experience from one of the enforcers and also from both of the little ones.
Yeah, this is a lot of
experience. Needs a ton of experience.
Wow.
Oh, it's gone already.
Yeah, but God, this is bad.
Disaster.
This is real bad. Yours once again with the farm tricks, as we saw on Echo Elf as well. And he takes his time, goes for the mercenary camp to, of course, have the Shadow Priest available and gets the big consumable here, so it can't be stolen from the Night Elf later on. Big potion of healing is, of course, nice. Would have been even better against the Warden, I think, but this is always nice to have. And yeah, therefore, he can go for the expansion quite safe, I think, with mercenary support. And we see the Flute of Accuracy for the Demon Hunter, also not the real best item. Of course, if he goes for Chims later, that would be cool, but apart from that, doesn't really make a difference.
Check this out, man. Neat little move. Jaws was walking away from the Merc camp he just took, and then expecting the Wisp to move in right then to position himself to steal the mercenaries, goes back in again to kill the Wisps. This is some high-level play right here. And now Mercenary still on cooldown. The Demon Hunter might be walking into a surround back here. He gets the Shadow Priest. Oh, but your surrounding skills. Demon Hunter gets out.
Yeah, it was... actually, the surrounding skills were quite strong on Sunday when he played the group stage. But not today. Warchief, by the way, with a counter expansion. And it's a very, very similar game to Echo Owls. But the Demon Hunter is dropping down to 150 HP. That's not what you want. Of course he can go back, but he has to use the Town Portal. He wants to go for the Archmage. Use the Town Portal now. This is once again a nice opening for yours.
And this is everything going according to plan. There's the Tree of Life now, though, and yours should know about this, and he has the time right now to kill it, to cancel it. But he also wants his level 3. He wants a bit of time. He probably wants a shop as well to heal up his Archmage. Yoss, I think, now missing out on an opportunity. This Tree of Life is easy pickings, but he has to move soon.
Yeah, the Ancient of War now going forward to protect this expansion. And yeah, the timing is kind of over. The Demon Hunter is back to full health. Four archers here, the Ancient of War here. Should be easy to deflect this push, but the expansion is always only halfway through.
And here get it.
Yeah, he can get it. Definitely four footmen and the Water Elemental. No dispel, no nothing for Warchief. And this expansion plan's cancelled.
More mercenaries coming in. The two trolls. The Archmage in trouble. Healing potion has to be used already. Interesting choice. By using this healing potion, basically everything he gets is the Wisp kill. Maybe it's gonna be a bit more. Of course, he also buys time.
He doesn't have a shop yet, so he had to use it. Demon Hunter almost blocking himself a bit. Warchief is playing with fire with his demon.
He has quite a bit of moon juice remaining. Could heal up now. Of course, he wants the human army gone. He wants time for his expo. We remember on Echo Isles, not even 2,000 gold behind was the expansion. This time, it's gonna be a lot later.
Okay, here comes the shop. I think, yeah, he needs power build and he does so. Tier 2 tech by Warchief has started, by the way, and he tries to build it up a second time. This is usually where Yoss has to be defensive, has to get the Arcane Tower most likely. But good timing of Warchief to kill that shop.
Oh, is he though?
Yeah, taking damage is enough. Mass repair. Oh, that's gonna be really close, but in the end, he is getting it. But he could use a lesser clarity, but no healing scroll.
Trying to go for some footmen here. He really wants some experience. He has denied quite a few of the creeps we remember from the Ancient of War camp. And he's still far away from level 3. I think if he had not denied the... Oh, the Demon Hunter, hold that thought. Boots of Speed will save him, though it's a good item. So yeah, he might be level 3 right now if he hadn't denied those creeps, and that would make such a big difference. But alright, he's not level 3, he's not too strong, but he is buying time, and I think this time the Expo should come up, the Tree of Life should come up. If Yoss was to commit his entire army, I think he could kill the tree. Do you think it would be worth it, or would that be too much to throw away just for a tree kill?
Yeah, well, he has still not started his tier 2, so I don't really would like Yoss to attack now and lose his entire base, because Warchief will have Dryads in a second, will have Bears in a few minutes, so this would be punished hard.
A player's forces are
lose the
attack.
Expo now. Or to kill him.
Alright. We have a lot of footmen. Again, Chinese style. Very few towers, but lots and lots of footmen. They only cost gold, no lumber. Doesn't slow down your tier 2.
And yeah, Yoss has lumber issues here. As we can see, the power build of the shop really costed a lot, and therefore he can't tech. He goes in with the defend upgrade now. But where is the tech? This is gonna be so super duper late. This is a major issue for the German.
A player's force. And comparing the two gold mines, actually it's not even gonna be so much later the expansion as it seems. Because of course the tree didn't have to walk. Now Yoss going onto the offensive again. He has 50 supply almost. Panda coming in now as well, by the way. Oh, the mud golem slow might lead to a surround. He's not trying to go for it. He just leaves the panda alone.
He expects the staff, I think. But there is none. Or maybe he thinks, okay, the panda has to come in sooner or later, and then I can try it.
Alright, here we go. Angel of War is here as well. Demon Hunter still not level 3. Still a bit of a problem. Here comes the Breath of Fire. There's a slow. And here comes the surround. Probably he can get it now. Boom, there we go. And there is no staff. He should have had the time. I don't even know. Maybe he has no shop, and the panda will die. Level 1, of course, he will be back soon. Finally level 3 for the demon. Jesus Christ, this took forever. Is he gonna be able to defend this? There is defend on the footman, so the archer is not too strong. The Demon Hunter really has to carry hard, but this is a decent army from Yoss.
Yeah, finally he gets rid of the Mud Golem, but the Berserkers, the Berserker is still alive, was close to being killed, but the Shadow Priest, his buddy, helped him, and here we go. Going for the Tree of Life, but he turns around, he does not want to take so much damage. But he deals so much damage, man. Tech has been started on the back of this. And the Blacksmith upgrade is coming too. Demon Hunter is still in the base. Panda is only now back to the battlefield. I think this is the time for Yoss to cancel this, man. There's nothing.
Yeah,
this is really strong mass repair.
Oh,
it's
God.
Way too late.
Oh, God.
Warchief is losing the expansion for the second time.
Wisps though. Is it going to be enough Breath of Fire? Where is it? He needs to get rid of this damage ASAP. But it's too late. Expo down, Yoss far ahead.
That's true, man. He's mining and mining and mining and mining. This is the tech here. It's also okay-ish now. But Warchief, yeah, with the first Dryads, what can he accomplish? There is no tier 3 for him.
He still has no shop, by the way. I think that was the biggest mistake this game, not getting a shop by a Rich. He should have built a shop between the two bases of his. He would have had a healing potion for the Demon Hunter to stay in longer. He would have had a staff on the Panda to not lose him. And then he could have held off this aggression. But forgetting one building, one shop. And suddenly, he is so far behind. Yoss rolling in money, man. He's like, what is that called? The guy called again from the DuckTales, the rich guy?
I don't know the English term.
Dagobert Duck. He has almost 2k gold. More and more is coming in. He's getting towers. He's getting his tech. His tech is finished, man. He's getting upgrades. And there is going to be a timing push coming very, very soon.
Oh, yeah. He's still not buying the production facilities, but there we go. First Arcane Sanctum, the second one will be coming up as well. But he has still lumber issues. It's time to go for the Shredder, man. You can't afford it. But it's not crap, so yeah, he goes for the Tree of Life again. And the damage is once again high enough. The Demon Hunter can't do anything against it. Two Berserkers can get rid of the thing as easy as humanly possible. This time, Lightning Shield, though. It's easier, but this is definitely a worth trade. Getting a few units killed And the Town Portal 4, an upcoming expansion, always go for it.
Okie dokie, Arcane Sanctum's almost done. Do we have a workshop?
Not yet.
We don't. As you said, he's really low on lumber.
Yeah. Mountain King is coming, and the lumber upgrade here as well. For Rich, still not on the way to tier 3. Mass Dryads. Only Dryads. And when the first mod teams appear, have fun.
I think Rich has to go for some sneaky harassment play. Get a Zeppelin, drop with Panda and Dryads. Demon Hunter keeps the Archmage busy or something like that. He needs to buy time for his expansion.
But he also is giving him the time now. Going into the upper part of the map, probably for his natural, for the shop, get some items, get some heal scrolls, spend that gold that you have.
Yeah, but look at the queue in the Arcane Sanctum. The time's ticking.
Yeah. That's right. 54 food already. The farms are coming up as well. Watch if he wants to cancel something now, or is looking for the army, because he feels that he's stronger at the moment. Level 4 Archmage though, heal scroll. That is a good investment. Replenishment potion, amazing as well. But so far it's only the Demon Hunter harassing. He has to be careful about his surround. There's the bolt. Is there a follow-up? Nope. Watch if blocks immediately.
He's being intercepted. Dryads coming from both sides. There is a TP here though, and he uses it, realizes he can't win this fight. It's too early. He doesn't have his critical mass.
This is so good of yours. He's portaling not to his main base, but to the expansion. And look what's almost finished. It is the expansion. Warchief on the other side, too greedy to go for a town portal. There's nothing he can do against this.
He's next to the shop though with a panda. He could buy a TP here.
He's walking straight past it.
Alright, but this is not too much damage. This is not mass mercenaries like last time. This is 5 footmen, 1 elemental, MK. Wisps are next to it to repair. Is he actually gonna get the kill again?
Looks like it. Stumbled on the wisp. No repair so far.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, here comes Warchief, though. Jumping into the back of yours with the 2 water elementals. Yeah, there is no repair. This should be it, man. Where's the panda? There's no breath of fire. For the 4th time, the expansion goes down. Holy moly.
Oh, my goodness. And what is he paying for this? Only footmen. Who
the
hell
portal.
Cares about footmen?
Yeah. They're actually pretty decent versus Dryads, of course, thanks to defend. And he does some kind of damage. Panda is level 3, but I think it's kind of weird that he doesn't really stick with the army. Losing a lot of potential with it. And look at the caster army of yours. There's already 3 breakers, 2 sorceresses. This time I can count.
Very good, very good. Everyone's improving here on Back to Warcraft.
Engine of Wind in the middle of the base, in the middle of the map, by the way. What's that for?
He still doesn't have a shop, by the way.
No shop, no tier 3. Yoss is going for the workshop. There's going to be mortar teams. And when there's mortar teams and a nice little blocker line from the breakers, what can...
Oh, he's committing into the main. There's no TP on him. That is really risky. And he thinks, yeah, better not do that. As he retreats out, now creeping on his opponent's side of the map. And again...
Fifth time. He should go for the upper right, I think. Just build an expansion there.
I don't know. I think it's too late for an expo. I think...
It's too late for basically everything.
Yeah. Too late for hope. Lots of money,
never
though.
Too late for hope.
Lots of money on Rich. But... Yeah, he's still tier 2.
Yeah, point
still
five.
Doesn't have a shop, which is really starting to trigger me, man. Staff of Preservation is a pretty good item.
Minehorn of Stormwind is not and will be sold. Even more gold for Richard.
But he's also playing this really passively, man.
Yeah, he's setting up towers at the bridge so he can crawl forward. So expansion will never, ever, ever come up here. And this time, yeah. Okay, this looks like he's listening to the cast, but of course we have a delay on it, so he can't. But there's an expansion in the upper right now.
Okay, might this be enough time still left in this game? As we said, Rich has a lot of gold. And so far, this army isn't too incredibly powerful for Yaz.
Ah, there's a Mountain King, though. 5 breakers. He has 1-0 upgrade. Mod teams have 1-0 upgrade. And it's only unarmored Dryads. It's not like he has bears. He doesn't have Reacher. He doesn't have Roar. But he has strong heroes. 4 and 3. That's pretty nice. Archmage is 4 as well, with the Mountain King once again struggling to find levels.
Demon Hunter also close to level 5. Getting there slowly. Level 3 mana burn, obviously great against anything. Town is under siege. But yeah, you're right. The heroes have to carry this. The dryads will not be winning the fight. Neither will the mercenaries. Is Yoss going to be pushing into the main where Rich will be forced to defend? Or is he going to keep on playing this slow and just, you know, take another base here as he's taking the natural of the Night Elf with peasants coming in and ivories? He's at 79 supply. So he might as well attack and trade. He's of course got the better economy and another expansion. Yeah.
This is really sneaky, very unusual by both players to go for the expansion right in front of their opponent's main bases. But the production buildings from Yoss is in the bottom left, so you can't really attack it very fast. On the other side, the item, the healing potion again, not a mana, not an invul, which would have been a little better.
Richard, 60 out of 60 now. He produced a bit. He bought some mercenaries, but it's only tier 2.
What is the Ancient of Wind for, by the way? There is no Hippogriff, as far as I know, no Fury Dragon, nothing. It's just 5 Dryads and the mass mercenaries now. And Yoss begins the siege with the mortar teams. 3 of them. I don't know how Rich can face this.
I know, this doesn't look like an 80 supply army to me. It's also still 2 footmen in here. Upgrades are okay-ish.
It's 20 foot advantage and he's in he's up in every single regard except the second hero. And here we go. Warchief needs a miracle, like this Breath of Fire. That was nice. 1 heal scroll, 2 heal scrolls available though. Mauler is so important here because he is the counter to the Breakers. And Warchief needs time. Warchief needs to win this. He's splitting his army, the Dryads, into the Mort team. This is a really nice move by the Englishman, but what's it worth?
Invisible cast here, saving a few units. Level 5 now for the Demon. Could burn the AM and would mean no more Water Elementals. And yeah, this was a big army, but not the strongest army ever. And it seems like the heroes can do it. The heroes can carry. More Mort teams dying as the last, second to last footman falls. But now he's retreating into the towers, and this is not where Warchief wants to follow. As the dust settles, the expansion has almost been entangled up here, now being attacked by the creeps. Hopefully, won't be losing another Tree of Life up there.
Did Yoss pull this or did this happen? Oh no, it's not. It's the usual creep spot here. So yeah, he's preparing this. He has to react, does so with the Demon Hunter. 3 potions on him, by the way. And yeah, really surprising how Warchief did this. Spitting the Dryads and getting in the face of the Mortar Teams, man. Such a smart move. We see it here and there from Lord Lyot, of course, the best Night Elf in the world currently.
Oh nice, he got a shop and a staff now.
Yep.
Very good.
It's working for him as well. The Mauler is alive, and as I mentioned, this is important. Oh, Yoss with towers and a rifleman against the expansion. I like this very much. He does not have to get away from Warchief's base. He can still put on the pressure. His second expansion is up. And yeah, he can do this with towers because Warchief has no time to face this.
And it's going to be really tough for Rich to deal with all of this. This is what Yoss likes. When you watch the stream, he always says you want to create multiple threats on the map where your opponent's attention will be divided, and it's really tough to deal with multiple threats, all of them, well, at the same time. Now, Rich has to deal with the towers, has to deal with the second expansion up here. At the same time, the attack is coming towards the main.
Yeah, Warchief knows, okay, the attack is coming, so I need my Demon Hunter in here. He uses a potion, so the big one is on cooldown. There was no Tele Staff. On the Demon Hunter, I would have loved that, but yeah, of course, 4 Dryads are missing now, and the Ogre Mauler is missing. 80 food for Yoss, and this is once again gonna be one of these games where we have amazing and big armies, and they will clash at one point.
And just a second ago, Yoss went into high upkeep. This means he doesn't want to take it late, he doesn't want to go tier 3, he doesn't want to buy time for more expos, he wants to kill him, right? Now, and he just killed one of the Ancients of Lore. Panda and Demon Hunter again have to carry Ultra Heart.
Indeed. 2 Mortar Teams only though. Stormbolt on the Panda. There is a lot of mana. The Demon Hunter is level 5.3. The potential for Metamorphosis is here. Here's the Breath of Fire. Very well done. Heal Scroll counters it immediately. The Mortar is in a good position. Level 2 on the MK finally. But the Mortar Teams, MVP of this game. The Panda is in trouble. Has a potion, but there's a bash. Using the potion now. There is another. Oh, there's no Stormbolt. No.
Well.
Whoa. The damage isn't high enough, though. The Mortar team's in a great position, and the Dryads and the numbers are falling. 57 versus 88. The Panda is coming back, and the Mortar finally dies. There's not a big opportunity for a Metamorph because everything is breakers. Demon Hunter 5.5, not too close to Metamorphosis, which could turn the game around. Or Invul Potion being used here. Mana Burn, no more Stormbolt, level 5 on the Archmage as well. Panda has another Breath of Fire, but getting feedback. Now the Breath of Fire is gone. The army of Warchief is archers and mercs.
And the Panda in trouble. There's no mana for a bolt for him. Fortunately, by the way, main gold mines have expired. Now the Tree of Ages wants to come in and fight, but he's actually blocking. The Demon Hunter has to retreat further into the back of the base where there is a new shop, but no more Ancients of Lore as the MK finally hits level 3. This makes things even more dangerous for the heroes, which are low already anyways. Now Mercenaries again trying to aid Warchief. Mass Wisps coming out for the detonate. He wants there to be no bolt, but there is one onto the Demon Hunter. Is he stunned? He can't use the potion. He dies, and that has to be it. Last Heal Scroll is being used by Yaws, but there's nothing remaining for Rich, basically. The Wisps detonating will not be winning this fight for him. He's not quitting yet, but we know this is basically over. All right, next Breath of Fire coming in, dealing a bit of damage, but the priests healing up everything. GG, well played. Yaws advances in the upper bracket.
Once again, the German is proving us all wrong. We doubted him, right? Once before the game. We shouldn't do that! We should not do that! Always up for a surprise, always so strong, man. Nerves of steel. And he throws Warchief once again down to the loser's bracket. What a fantastic game on Terranos. Despite the long, the late tech, the expansion cancelings, man.
Yep, one in the game.
Fantastic timings.
In general, I think Yaws played really well this series, really well. But I also think this was not Rich's best performance. Terranos stand may be the most obvious mistakes, as he forgot the shop, got his Panda slowed and killed because there was no staff, he had no potion on the Demon Hunter, and suddenly he notices, huh, crap. These footmen and mercenaries are taking down my expansion. This isn't supposed to look like this. And then, of course, it was a downward spiral. Map number one, Echo Isles, he also lost with a decentish advantage because he had Moonwells too late. He had not enough to keep his second hero again, the Panda, alive. Again, kind of that, losing him the game. He forgot the movements twice, actually. He was stuck on 50 for a long time, then he was stuck on 70 for a long time. He was also short on lumber. He should have had more wisps for more upgrades and stuff. Yeah, Yaws playing really well, but Rich not in championship form currently.
Yeah.